Now, pH is something that people have heard of. I can remember as a child, they talked about a deodorant. It was a secret deodorant. And the big deal was it was pH balanced for a woman, okay? Strong enough for a man, but pH balanced for a woman. I have absolutely no idea what that means, but they would put a piece of litmus paper on there and prove it. So pH is a familiar term, and it sounds very scientific, I'm sure. That's why they use that in that commercial. So let's talk about what this pH scale is. And it is our way of really quantifying, giving a number value to how acidic something is or how basic a solution is. All right, so it is just quantifying it. Oop, let's look. Well, we'll get to that little bottom part here in a minute. My animation didn't show up right. Okay, here is the definition of pH. Flat out, its definition. It is the negative log of the H3O plus concentration. Okay? You could give somebody the H3O plus concentration and say something like this. The H3O plus concentration is 1.0 times 10 to the minus 7 molar. So that is the information about the H3O plus concentration in pure water. Or you could take the negative log of that number and you could say the pH is equal to 7.00. That says exactly the same thing as that, but takes a whole lot less keystrokes. You don't have to do powers, which used to be a really big deal when you had a typewriter. You had to work really hard to do those powers. It's really nothing more than a time saver, base 10 way of dealing with numbers. Let's just look at this value for just a minute. Basically, this power is giving you the front number. Now, it's not always going to be exactly that value, but it's going to be very close to that value. And these front numbers are giving you what comes after the decimal place. So that's the Sig Fig rule, okay? However many places you have right here, let me underline it. Whatever you have places right here is how many places after the decimal point you have. And that is the rule of Sig Figs when you have logarithms. Okay, so it is a unitless number. It is just basically a time saver, a writing saver, a typing saver. But it got so ingrained into the system that they're not going to let go of it. Okay, so we have to learn the system. That's how we talk about acidity and basicity. All right, so acidic solutions would have any kind of concentration that's greater than this. This is pure water, right? And this is 7. If this is pure water and we have concentrations greater than this, then we're going to end up with pHs less than 7. So let me pick a number that's greater than this. Would 1.0 times 10 to the minus 6 be a bigger concentration? First glance, you might not see it, but a bunch of zeros and then a 1, one less zero and a 1. This is a bigger number, okay? You might want to write it out just to prove it to yourself. What would be the pH in this case? It would be 6.00. And so pHs that get lower than 7 are going to be acidic solutions. Already got the neutral one up there, okay? So what are you going to do when it's basic? Well, when it's basic, you're adding OH minus. If OH minus is going up, then the H3O plus is going down. So you're going to have concentrations of H3O plus that are less than 10 to the minus 7, and that would be pHs that are greater than 7. So let's get an example of this. Would this be smaller than pure water? Is that a smaller number? Why it is. And this is a pH of 9, okay? 9.00. Big pHs are basic, little pHs are acidic. All right, well, that P function just means take the negative log of what comes after it. So if you're going to do POH, you're going to take the negative log of the OH minus concentration, okay? So you're going to see POH values. And the pH plus the POH is equal to 14. Let me show you where that comes from, and maybe it'll help you remember it. We know that Kw equals H3O plus times OH minus. We learned that in our last lesson. If we're at 25 degrees Celsius, we know that this value is 10 to the minus 14, right? And so we've got that in there. I'm just filling that part in. Now the next thing I want to do is take the negative log of both sides. If I take the negative log of this side, and I don't have room to stick it in there, so I'm going to take the negative log of this side. Well, the negative log of 1 times 10 to the minus 14 is 14, okay? Since I have 1.0 there, I could actually put a couple decimal points there. And if I take the negative log of a product, that is the negative log of the first number plus the negative log, I'll put a big thing, negative log of the second number. Well, what's the negative log of H3O plus? That's pH. What is the negative log of OH minus? That's POH. So that is equal to 14. It is a real quick and easy way to get between these two things is just to use this equation. This maybe will help you remember it. I don't know, but that's the only reason I show you that derivation. You don't have to derive it. So you've got this equation, you've got this equation, and you've got this equation. And there's just basically three things. If you've got those three equations, okay, you can get between a whole bunch of different variables that we're going to see in just a minute, but not yet. Let's look at our next slide. You just want to become familiar with these trends, and I've kind of talked you through these trends already. We talked about, and I always talk about it in terms of H3O plus concentration, right? Right here is pure water. If you have more than that, it's acidic. So over here is the acidic end of things. These are where the concentrations are bigger, okay? So this is 1, this is 0.1, this is 0.01. These are bigger than 10 to the minus 7. As you go from this line to this line, what did we do? We used the negative log of the top line to get the run right underneath it, okay? And so we see low pHs are the acidic, high pHs are basic. And then how do we go from this line to this line? We use that 14 is pH plus POH. So in other words, 14 minus pH will give you the POH. So basically they're flipping. Where you have low pHs, you will have high POHs when it is acidic. So that is kind of the connection between these three, and you're going to want to be able to know those by numbers so that you can check your work. If you know when you're dealing with an acidic solution and you end up with a pH of 12, well, you've done something wrong. If you know you've got a basic solution and you come up with a POH of 9, then you've done something wrong. If you know these connections, you'll be set. All right, so I told you, and let's go back two slides. If you know those three boxes, then you can go between any one of these four variables. And you're going to have to do this over and over and over again in this chapter, okay? Let's consider going between these two, okay? If you know the H3O plus, we know that pH is equal to the negative log of the H3O plus concentration. We learn that. Take that equation and solve for H3O plus. Well, look at the minus over there, and you have minus pH is the log. How do you get rid of the log? You take 10 to the x. So 10 to the minus pH is equal to H3O plus. I write this because this equation and this equation look nothing alike, do they? They just don't look like they have anything in common except the variables. But they are actually the exact same equation, just solved for the opposite variable. So we will use this equation to go there. We would certainly use an analogous form over here. If we want POH from the negative log of the OH minus concentration, we can do that. Or, whoops, I did it again. I did it again. Or we can say that 10 to the minus POH is equal to the OH minus concentration. Well, how would we go between here and here? Well, we've seen that equation already. Kw equals the H3O plus concentration times the OH minus concentration. And how do we go from here to here? Well, we have that 14 equals pH plus pOH. So now we've got these equations and we can get between them. Now, did we have to have this equation? It wasn't on the previous slide. To go from H3O plus to OH minus? No. You could go one step, two step, three step. So you don't have to have that equation, but it's one that we already know and we could utilize it to save us a little bit of time. But you very, very often will need to go between those four things. Okay, so now we're going to practice going between those four components. We've got a table here, and we're just going to start off and practice filling some in. You see some Q1 and Q2. That's where you're going to answer some questions. I'll pause and let you answer those. So let's go to the first empty box in the top row there, and that is to calculate the OH minus concentration when we know that the H3O plus concentration is equal to 2.3 times 10 to the minus 6. We got lots of boxes there that we can go to. Which one do you want to go to first? Well, I want to choose that first empty box there. Whenever I want to go between H3O plus and OH minus, I will pull out this equation. Kw is H3O plus times OH minus. That's its job, is to go between those two things. Since I'm telling you it's 25, and by the way, if you're working a problem and they don't say anything about temperature, it was an oversight. Assume it's 25, because if it's anything else, we have to tell you and we have to give you a different K value. Okay, so we know that Kw is 1.0 times 10 to the minus 14. We know that H3O plus is 2.3 times 10 to the minus 6, so we could solve for OH minus. Now, I want you to make sure you stop and plug this into your calculator and get the right answer, because a lot of people don't use their exponent key and they end up getting a wrong answer even though they have it all set up correctly. Okay? You should be using your exponent key when you solve that. Now, I don't like the way that line is looking, so let me see if I can get my pen writing a little bit better. Okay, so we have the OH minus concentration now given to us, and it is 4.4 times 10 to the minus 9. Okay? And that's in molarity. We'll write our unit there. So I know that value. The next box across the top row there is we're trying to end up getting the pH. Well, to get the pH, I simply take the negative log of the value of 2.3 times 10 to the minus 6. We'll make sure that we use a little bit of information about Sig Figs as we do this, as we start practicing this. The value I get when I plug the negative log of this number into my calculator is 5.64. Now remember, this is basically telling you where the decimal place is. It is 6 this direction, okay? That first number is keying off of that. It's not always exactly that number, but it's close to that number. Okay, and the 2.3 is what's giving us the latter part. So we would have this 6.4, whether it was 2.3 times 10 to the minus 6 or 2.3 times 10 to the minus 1. It's coming off of that. The front number changes with that power. So however many places you see here total is how many decimal places you see right there. And that's the pH. Now, you have a couple choices of how to get the pOH. You could take this number and take the negative log of that number. pOH is the negative log of 4.4 times 10 to the minus 9. That is one way you could do that. You could also take this and know that 14, okay, it's just not writing very well. There it goes, maybe this is better. 14 is equal to 5.64 plus pOH. So either way, I should get the exact same value for pOH, and in this case, the value is 8.36. Okay? pOH right here is 8.36. So now you stop and look at this information and tell me, is this solution an acidic solution or is it a basic solution? Well, it depends on how you want to look at it. The quickest and easiest for me is if this is less than 7, I know it's acidic. But if its concentration is greater than 1 times 10 to the minus 7, I know it's acidic. So those are things that I tend to look at. All right, let's go to the next one. The next row across, we are given a pH, and we're being asked to fill everything in. Well, let's fill in that first far left box and get the H3O plus concentration from the POH. We know the relationship between pH and H3O plus is this, okay? And we went through this derivation earlier, but the relationship between these two that looks very different is that if you take 10 to the minus pH, you're going to get the H3O plus concentration. So I'm going to take 10 to the minus 5.75. If I take 10 to the minus 5.75, then that is going to give me the value of 1.8 times 10 to the minus 6. And it's a molarity, so I'll put a capital M. You just have to remember that because it doesn't come out. This is a unitless number, but it is in molarity. So now, let's look at this sig fig wise. The front number is giving you the power, essentially. These two is how many we have here. So this is the correct number of significant figures in my answer. Now I want you, from this piece of information, to come up with the OH minus concentration. Now, I'm not sure which way you went with it, but to get the OH minus concentration, I would probably choose this one because I know the H3O plus concentration. So 1.0 times 10 to the minus 14, which is Kw, is the H3O plus concentration, which was 1.8 times 10 to the minus 6, times the OH minus concentration. And when you solve for the OH minus concentration, you end up with the OH minus concentration equal to 5.6 times 10 to the minus 9. Okay? So that is how you come up with that answer. Now, this would also be an acidic solution. A pH of 5.75 I know is lower than 7. I know it is acidic. So I'm going to challenge you all to go ahead and fill out this table. There's one of two ways that you can check your answer. I will post the grid with all the answers in it so that you can work through it and see if you're getting the right answers. And if you struggle with it, there will be a supplemental video that you can choose to watch in which I have worked through all of the rest of these for you just to help you find your mistake or to help you get past any struggles that you might do. So you're going to finish this table. So what are we going to do next? Not all acids have the same strength, okay? Some acids are strong, some acids are weak, and we're going to talk about the difference between strength of acids and how you know how strong an acid is.